Welcome back to News Channel 8 this morning, Sunday, taking a look at Project Economy for your coverage this morning. If you haven't done your taxes, well, it's still time, and it's time to get on the ball. KCCI News Channel 8 Steve Collins sat down with our very good friend Kurt Pearson from Compass Financial for some good tips to keep in mind.
If you're looking for financial advice, I've got the guy, Kurt Pearson, here from Compass Financial. And Kurt, we're about at tax time, and there are a bunch of things people should keep in mind right now.
Yeah, sometimes with the frenetic pace of waiting until the final hour, it might be easy to miss some of the deductions and some of the key points that we need to be taking a look at. So some of those items, of course, include the home buyer tax credit. If you purchased a home in 2010, you may qualify for a really nice home buyer tax credit that's out there. Of course, the typical interest rate deductions, some of the energy efficiency credits that are still available out there, be sure you bring that up to your tax preparer. Some of the basic deductions about interest and home interest, mortgage interest, those sorts of things are still on the books. So just very important for people, even though it's getting down to the final hour, to still be very thorough, because we don't want them paying any more than they absolutely have to when it comes to that bottom line on their taxes.
Yeah, money is a good thing. Keeping it from the IRS is a good thing, too, legally.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. But there are some things that people often miss on their tax returns, aren't there? Mistakes that are somewhat common.
Right. I mean, the IRS has come out with their list of common errors. The first one right at the top is getting the Social Security number wrong on the return. And so when the IRS begins to process the return, they just go, oh, wait, this isn't matching up, and of course, it kicks everything out. Another common error that the IRS finds is just bad math. Things don't add up correctly, and that's really an interesting one, especially in this day and age where even if you're doing your own taxes, you're probably using a computer program of some sort, but evidently there's still a number of returns done by hand, by longhand, and so be sure and double check your math if you're preparing your return that particular way. Another common mistake is getting the numbers wrong in terms of like a child care provider or some other tax form that you received and transposing it onto the tax return incorrectly, which is obviously going to kick it out, and you'll be getting a letter, you know, in subsequent months about, hey, some things aren't quite coming together correctly. So just very important to go back over the return. Again, in the final hour, we may skip some steps. We may take some shortcuts. It's just very important to check, double check, and triple check to make sure all the numbers are correct and all the details are accurate.
Okay, you're a guy who works with people from various income levels. Is getting a professional tax preparer a good idea?
Boy, the tax code has just become so complicated. You know, we in our industry jokingly pull out the tax form from, when was it, the 1920s. Basically, it was one page. But now, of course, the tax code has become so complicated. Always a good idea, especially in this area of eliminating errors and problem areas. It's very good to get the professional to at least take a look and make sure that, you know, everything is accurate. Even if you find yourself up against the deadline and you don't have your taxes done, it's important you can go ahead and pay your tax or what you estimate you owe, get your tax and file an extension, get your taxes done a little bit later if you need more time to gather the information. That's a strategy that some folks use.
Because you do want to get this right, because if you don't, it could cost you a lot of money.
Exactly. The taxes or the interest and the penalties on unpaid tax are pretty stiff.
Okay. Kurt Pearson, Compass Financial. If you need to get in touch with Kurt, if you need any financial advice, here's how you do that. Thank you, Kurt.
Yep.